Je me baladais sur l'avenue. Today, I would like to demonstrate and explain a little bit about wine opening. When you cut the foil, you have two choices, I would say. You can either cut the foil at the level of the upper lip, right here, or under. Usually it was cut under when it was made of lead, so that you wouldn't contaminate the wine with any lead product.
Il y a tout ce que vous voulez aux Champs-Élysées.
This corkscrew has a screw that is coated with Teflon, and that really helps a lot when you open the wine, because as the screw goes down in the cork, it glides in the cork, as opposed to ripping the cork and making a sawdust, which would go into the wine after. The first thing though, you cut the foil, so use that little blade here on that is a good blade, it's a rotated edge, and it cuts the foil very nicely. So when you do that, you place the blade under the lid and you turn the bottle. When you turn that like this, you make a fine cut, and then you can decapsulate. Then you have the cork that is exposed, and now you can click that, get rid of that, open your corkscrew, and really basically you want this to be in the middle. So if you look at the pointing thing here, if you put it in the center, that's not going to be in the middle. It's going to be a little bit at the opposite. So use your eye and aim it in the middle, and you turn nice and in the center and vertical. And you can see, even though I can see that this is a plastic cork, it goes down very easily. You do not have to, there is absolutely no strength involved. And then after you use that, and really, it's very easy. This is very smooth to the hand, it's very good. And then the second stage. And then at this part, I would say go slow, because you don't want to pop the cork. You want to see, it was really smooth there. There was no shock of air. And the wine like this is not really disturbed in any way. White wine glasses versus red wine glasses. There are two aspects that you have to consider. First aspect is the aromas. White wine, we have a consensus that in white wine you have less aroma, or they are more delicate than in red wines. Bigger aromas in red wines, they necessitate a bigger volume. That's why red wine glasses are generally bigger. The other aspect is the oxidation part. Red wines benefit from oxidation. So in a bigger bowl, you have a larger surface of contact with the air. That is the reason why, generally speaking, red wines are bigger than white wine glasses. When pouring the wine, the way to hold the bottle is to have your hand on the back label. So when you pour the wine, everybody that you pour the wine to will be able to see the label, to read the label. That's important when you pour the wine. Then after, when you pour the wine, you have to be careful not to hit the rim of the glass, because some glasses are very fragile. And what you do is you go for it, don't hesitate, go for it. And when you move, just give it a twist like this. And then there is no bleeding on the tablecloth. When I started to learn about wine, what I wanted is to taste as many wines as possible. So, but I wanted to be able to taste the wine and then to preserve the bottle, so that I could have the bottle with friends and family. So what I did is, I got this kind of corkscrew, which is a blade corkscrew. And really basically, I would cut the foil very nicely, or remove the foil without arming the foil by sliding it over the neck, and then I would open this like this, put the blade inside, and that requires a little bit more of of strength, this one. But really, basically, when you do that on a fresh bottle, what you have is you have the cork that is intact and the bottle that is practically intact too. So I would take my taste, which is very little, little taste like this. I would put one or two or three marbles, whichever, to make up for the volume of wine that I've taken, so that to bring the wine at the same level as before, so that there would not be any oxidation. Then I would put the cork back, push the cork to its position and put the foil back as if nothing had happened. But really, basically, you could hear the marbles inside. But then I would have had the wine tested. I would know what the wine tasted like. I would know it would be in which condition it would be. And I would be able to serve the wine much later as if I had just not opened the wine. So that was the wine in two parts. First the tasting, then the enjoyment.
Il suffisait de te parler pour t'apprivoiser aux Champs-Élysées.